Okay, so in this lesson, what we will learn? We'll learn how to add a node dynamically or how to remove a node dynamically. The operations which we have performed yesterday. The operations. Day 4. In the day 4, the program name is what? 1.html. So this program we have done, we had done the adding a dynamic element using document object. We'll convert this program using jQuery now. Okay. So for this, we have already created a folder day 5, and there's already 3 program, 1.css, 1.html, 1.js. So one good thing today is that we do not have to worry about the UI, how to create the UI. So let's start with the program number 1. That means how to add a node using jQuery. So in this program, you can see that right now we have not added jQuery into our project. So let's go and search here jQuery CDN. Okay, let's go to the second link. That means jQuery CDN. Select any version. We'll select the minified one, and you can copy here. I hope there is no problem. This is a script to include an external JS, and the link of the file is to some remote server. That's called CDN. That is called CDN, stands for the Content Delivery Network. Okay. So now, once it has been added into our project, what we can do? We can go to our program now, day 5, 1.html. The UI is same, there is no change in the UI. Only thing you can change, you can cross check that another jQuery has been added, another source has been added into our project, source folder has been added, and you can cross verify here again by typing what? Dollar. Okay, once we are done, now let's do what? We are quite familiar with the syntax of the JavaScript, that means the method. So if you remember from yesterday's program, on click we are calling what? Add new element. Let's have a small demo. When we are clicking, we are calling add new element, and this we are performing using normal JavaScript object. So now this time we are going to do what? Add new element using jQuery. Add new element using jQuery. Okay, so let's modify this program first. So now let's go step by step. So can I write this line instead of this? Is there any problem? So how does the dollar is getting? The meaning of dollar is the jQuery. What we are trying to do? Select all the div element using what? Using jQuery. So now can I remove this? Okay. Let's go one by one. First child means what? Blue box. That means this blue box. Okay. And the button element is the okay, delete box. Okay. So can I write the alternate version using jQuery? Okay, so can I copy this? Okay, and instead of writing, what we have to write here? container.children.first. Is there any problem? The children will return all the children, and what do we want? We want the first children. So we are calling the first method. These are the utility method provided by the jQuery. So now we can delete our first line, second box. So can I make a query of this? So here what we have to write? Children, then first, and on first what we can do? Next. That means we are moving to the next element of the first child. Next element of the first child itself is what? Blue box. Okay, we will try it out, all this, and then we are making what? Clone. So that means for each line whatever we have written using document object, we are making an alternate version using jQuery. So now, can you make an alternate version of this? Can we make? How? So an ref element. Ref element means represents what? Blue box. So can I call ref element instead of clone node? What we need to pass here? Clone. And again, instead of passing the clone node, so the new element blue, new element blue, and here what we can do, making a clone of what? New element orange. Okay, and where we are adding, that means we are, whatever the new element which we have created, what we can do, we can add, where we need to add to the container. What is the container? That is the div. So we have a reference of this. So what we can write here? Append. Okay, let's see. Shall we run the program now? But if you run the program, what we have to do, instead of calling the add new element, what shall we call? Add new element using jQuery. So let's go to the one.html and let's modify this program and let's call it what? Add new element using jQuery. Is it clear? Let's go to the browser. Let's refresh the page. We are on day 5 and running our first program. Okay. Let's open the developer console also. Why so? There is a small region. I want you people to understand the debugging. Let's go to the sources tab. Okay. Under the sources tab, where we'll go? Into the one.js. Why so? So that you can look out your source program. We are not interested in the add element. I am putting a one tick by clicking on the line number 21 at the beginning of the program. Okay, why so? So that we will execute, we will inspect the flow of the program. So I am clicking, where I am clicking? On the blue box. Okay, can you see the execution has been stopped? Let me. Now, is it visible now? Okay, that means the execution has been stopped. Where the execution has been stopped? At the beginning of the program. So now let's go step by step. So on the top, you can see that there is an arrow, a rounded arrow. If you click on the rounded arrow, either here at the top or at here. Can you see my mouse? Okay, that represents one. If I click over there, we will go to the next line. So let's go to the next line. So now we can inspect what is the value of our local variable. The value of the container is what? There are three elements has been, okay, there is a container has been returned. Okay, let's go to the next line. What has been returned? Div. Can you see it has been highlighted? Can you see it has been highlighted? Yes. Okay, now let's go to the next line. Okay, so now if you are using a debug point, there is another advantage that whatever the local variable you have declared, you can also access in the console. Are you getting the point? When you can access the local variable in your console? At the time of debugging only. So right now, this, how many variables we can access? Container, reference element 1. Let's try to access here. Where? Container. Why we are able to access this? Because our program is in which mode? Debugging mode. It has not completed the execution. Okay. Now, if I try to access the new element blue, will I be able to access? No. Right now, why? Because that line, line number 30, has not been executed. Okay. So if you want to access the line next variable, so that line must finish the execution. Okay. So the point is, where we have reached, new element blue, new element orange has been created. Now what we are trying to do, we are appending into what? Container. So there is some change. It is behaving very irresponsibly. So let me check what is the problem. Shall we start now? Okay. So what is the problem here when we are making Why such kind of issue is coming? Because, okay, let's discuss this. If we compare with our last program, what was the query selector guarantees? It returns only one element. Are you getting the point? But there is no such guarantee with the $div. What it will do? It will return all the div element. So this container represents all the div element. So in which we are interested? First one. So instead of that, what we can also write? Container. So this will be the right way, okay? But still, this container can represent, can be used in multiple div. So still I will use what? Container dot first. No, this is fine. This is fine. That means on the first child, we are appending. The first represents whom? Dot first represents whom? Let's have a look here. Now you can see the application has been hanged because we have not used the added the element properly. So what I have to do? Okay, in this program, let's go to the console. Let's one more time, just repeat. So what is the problem was happening? If I simply type div, what does it return? It returns all the div. It is not equivalent to your query selector, because query selector returns only one div. So if you want only first ones, if I want only first, so what I will write? First. Okay, is it clear? Okay, so what we can do? Let's try to modify this program. So here what we have written, actually you can say container ref. Here we are calling first, and on first we are appending. The first represents, actually the first represents what? The container. Okay, so if I add, so now you can see that it has been added successfully. So let's do one more time. Let's open the console. Let's open the developer tool. Let's go to the sources one more time. And let's try to debug the program one more time. Is it clear? We can go one by one, step by step, and what you can do. So only change I have done what? Container dot first. Why? Because container contains all the div element. Is it clear? So in this way we are able to do what? Successfully add a node. Not this time using document object, this time using what? Alternate version, that's called jQuery. Okay, now I will do one more thing here in this program. Let me make a copy of this. I will reduce this program further. How many lines of program are there? I think 10 lines of program. Let's try to reduce it using version 2. So instead of writing everything, so can I write, now tell me here, instead of writing in a two lines, can I write something like this? Instead of container, can I write something like this? Okay, so do I require this? So can I remove this line? Okay, so instead of ref element, okay, let it be, because it will become too large. And again here for the container, what we have to do? So how many lines of program we have saved? Two lines. Again, there is no meaning of, again what we can do? Can I write here? And can I write here dot clone? So how many lines of program will be there? Can I write blue box, and can I write decision orange box? So can you see the advantage of the jQuery? Once you understand it, it has become very easy to use by just chaining, and it will reduce the number of line of the program. Why I have written that both the version of the program? Second version of the program, so that you can make a comparative study. with the document object. Okay, and this the third version is the second version of this program is the smarter version, which actually getting used practically. Okay, so let's try to call this method from where the program. Okay, shall we refresh the program? Let's open sources tab and let's check it out whether that program has been called or not. Now where I'm putting the debug point, line number 38, and if you try to click here, now where the call is going, okay, or if you don't want to execute line by line, what you can do, there is some blue arrow. So if you click on blue arrow, the program will go. Is it clear? So both the version of the three version of the program is available, how to add a node dynamically. Okay, now you people can go through this video and study it further. So our next task is what, how to remove a node.